Hello everyone, welcome to Java J2EE tutorial. In this session we will be discussing the installation guidelines and setting up of our environment for executing the Java program. In order to develop Java program and execute the program, we need to follow some guidelines in setting up our environment. The first step, the first guideline is to install JDK. JDK stands for Java Development Kit. It is a tool that provides us with an environment to develop and execute the Java programs. JDK, it is a tool which provides us an environment to develop and execute the Java programs. We can get the JDK tool from the Oracle website for learning purpose. The JDK is available for different platforms. For Windows, it's an executable file. For Linux, it is tar.gz. Basically, it is a form of a RAR file, compressed version. We have Windows on our machine. When we download this JDK from the Oracle website, it will be an executable format. It will be of something this type. This is an exe file. It is very similar to installation of any other softwares. JDK can also be installed as it is. We will see how to install JDK. Double click on that exe file. Next, it is asking for the JDK installation path. By default, it is choosing C:\programfiles/java/jdk. We will leave the default installation path, but it can also be changed to any other locations of our choice. On our machine, we have C, D, E and F. It can also be installed in any one of the drive, C, D, E and G, any drive it is. We have selected the default JDK installation path, which is the OS drive in our case. It is installing now. Once the installation process is completed, we will see the JDK installation path. What are all the files that are available in the path? Once the JDK installation is completed, we will see the files and folders that are created by the JDK tool for us to create or to develop and execute any Java program. Why we need this JDK tool? Before understanding JDK, why programming languages are required? Programming languages are required to reduce the human efforts with respect to performing some huge computational works. To perform some tasks, depending upon a requirement, there are so many programming languages are there. C, C++, Java, C Sharp, Python, PHP, etc. But we have to remember that our machine, our processor, can understand only zeros and ones. It can understand only numbers, zeros and ones. But all our programs are being written in human readable format. For example, our C or C++ program, we see some of the keywords like include, stdio, void, main, everything, whatever the programs that we write in any of the programming languages are in human readable format, which is not understandable by the machine. Our programming languages are completely independent of the processor. So, it is required to have a tool which converts that human readable program into machine understandable language. Our machine can understand, our processor can understand only the machine language. So, it is very much required to convert our human readable programs into machine understandable programs. With respect to Java program also, the same comments holds good. Whatever the program we write, it has to be converted to the corresponding machine language. In order to do this task, we need to have a tool what is called as JDK. In order to convert any programming language from human readable format into the machine understandable format, there are two. One is compiler and another one is the interpreter. A compiler takes the program that is the source code and it converts the source code into the machine language. Similarly, the interpreter also does the same job, but in case of a compiler, the complete source code, it was converted to a machine language, and that code we used to call it as an object file. But in case of an interpreter, the same source code, it is being converted to a machine language, but not in an object file format. It converts the source code into the machine language when the program is being executed. Compiler and interpreters are used to convert the human readable programs into machine understandable language. Compilers usually convert the complete source code at once and creates an object file or an executable file. That executable file, when it is executed, it is in a machine language code. But in case of an interpreter, the same programming language, it is executed in parallel. Each and every statement is being converted into machine language, and the statement and that statement is being interpreted. So we can have a comparison from between the compiler and the interpreter. Compiler usually runs faster because we have an object file or executable file which is easily understandable by the machine. But in case of an interpreter, there is no concept of an executable file. The programming language, it is directly fed into the interpreter tool. Basically, the compiler and the interpreters are a software tool. This source code, when it is given to the interpreter, instead of interpreting the complete code, each and every statement will be converted to the corresponding machine language, and each every statement will be interpreted independently. So the compiler obviously runs faster than the interpreter. Our Java program, it is a bit different. It is both compiled and interpreted. Some of the popular compiler oriented programming languages are C and C++. The interpreted programming languages are Python and Perl. But our Java is different. It is both compiled and interpreted. Why it is both compiled and interpreted, we will discuss in the later. Our Java programs are both compiled and interpreted. Our JDK installation is successful. Within C drive, program files, a folder Java, it is being created. Within this, we can see the JDK and the JRE. JDK, this is the JDK installation path. All these folders, it has been created by our JDK installation. We can see the bin folder, include, JRE folder, lib folder. Each and every folder are used at the execution time, run time. We will be concentrating on this bin folder. This bin folder has lot of applications files which are very much required for developing and executing of our Java program. This is the default JDK installation path that we have selected. It can also be installed in any other drives that are available on our machine. We have chosen the default OS drive default installation path. Our first Java program, let us develop that prints a simple text message onto our screen. We should be able to display some text onto our screen. So, with respect to learning any programming language, it is a very good practice to develop a simple text message at a very first basic level. Now, our first question is, where we have to write the Java program? Our first question, where to write how should be our Java program structure? With respect to structure, how to set up our environment to execute the Java programs? Our JDK installation is successful. Where we have to write the Java programs? When we use C or C++, we used to have an editor that is Turbo C, which is both a editor as well as a compiler. It has been inbuilt in that tool. Even for Java, there are integrated development environments like Eclipse, IntelliJ, NetBeans. So many popular editors are available. But since we are all in the learning process, let us start learning from the scratch with the help of a very basic text editor that is available on our Windows operating system, that is nothing but Notepad. So let us go to the Notepad. Class Hello World. So we are introducing to the world of Java program. Public static void main, string args, system.out.println. So this is our very first basic program in Java, which prints hello world onto our screen. So this is our first Java program which prints hello world onto our screen. We know very well in our C and C++ programming language, we used to have a function printf in C and cout in C++. These two are the functions which prints something onto our console. The same functionality in Java, it is being provided by system.out.println function. In Java, functions are called as methods. Both methods and functions are one and the same. The system.out.println is a function which prints something on our console. Whatever we pass within the parenthesis, everything gets displayed onto our console or a screen. Our first line has a keyword class. Every Java program should start with a class keyword followed by a valid identifier name. All the real world objects that whatever we see, it could be a building, it could be a person, it could be an animal, everything will be having a name. Similarly, each and every class should have a name. In our case, our class name is Hello World. So we identify this class with the name Hello World. Open the parenthesis, closing the parenthesis. Every statement, every function or a method that whatever we write in our Java program, everything should come within the class. In our case, our class our very first basic program, Hello World, it is having one main function. This main function, it is very similar to our C program, that we have a void main in our C programming language. Similarly, in our C++ also, the same thing, void main. Main is a function. In Java, the main function is available, which is an entry point to execute. If you want to enter into a house, you need to have a door. So that is your entry point into the house. Similarly, for your Java program, the entry point is the main method. The structure of the main method is public, static, void, main. Within parentheses, the main function, it is accepting one parameter, a string array parameter. But for time being, it is very difficult to know what is public, what is static. But we know void and main. This is a parameter accepting. Accepting this function is accepting one string array. It is a one-dimensional. It is a one-dimensional string array. We will see all these keywords, public means what, static, everything we will see in our upcoming video sessions. But at the end of this today's session, we should be able to develop at least one Java program that prints something onto our console. The structure is similar to this. It is the same. The structure of any Java program is to have a class, and within the class we have to declare all our functionality, whatever the properties we want, whatever the variables we want, whatever the functions we want, everything has to be declared within a class. A class should have a valid identifier name. The name represents with which we can access the properties of that class or the methods of that class. Our Hello World is a class which is having one main method. When we execute any Java program, if it wants to display something, it is a very first basic program. Our basic program is having one main method, which is very, very important, so that when execution is happening, so our machine enters into this main function and executes whatever the statements are there. In our case, this main method, it is having only one statement, system.out.println of hello world. That means it is printing a text hello world onto my monitor. But how to execute this program? There are few steps that we have to follow in order to execute the program. First of all, we have written this program in the notepad, but this is not a program as of now. It is just a simple text that whatever we have written here. But if you want to make this as a Java program, we need to save the file as a Java file. When we save the notepad file, so when we save the notepad file, the default extension that what we get is .txt, but all our Java file should have the extension .java. All our Java file should have the extension .java. Then what should be the file name? It is very important to note that whichever the class is having the main function, then the name of that class will become the file name of my Java. Whichever the class is having the main method, then that class name will be the file name of my Java program. So in our case, the class that is having the main method is my Hello World class. So this Hello World identifier name is my Java file name. If I want to save this Java file, I have to select the JDK installation bin path. So this is the JDK installation bin path. We have to select that path. Path selection is done. Now, what should be the name of the Java file? Whichever the class that is having the main method, that class name will be the file name of the Java. So hello world is our Java. So let us save our hello world.java in the bin directory. We have successfully created our first Java program in the bin directory. The .java file has been created within the bin directory. Our very first Java program is to print some simple text onto our console. The structure of the program is similar to this. It goes in this way. Every statement or the functions that whatever we write, it has to be encapsulated within a construct that is called as a class. Every class will be having a name. We have to give a name to the class. In our case, we have given a name to our class as Hello World. This Hello World class is having one main method. Method is nothing but functions, which is of the syntax public static void main string array. It is accepting one string, one dimensional array as the parameter, which can be used as a command line arguments. Within the main method, within opening parenthesis and the closing parenthesis of the main method, we have only one statement, system.out.println, whose task is to display some text on my console. It is very similar to the printf and cout statements of C and C++ programs. So we have successfully saved this file as a hello world.java, and it is saved in the bin directory, the installation path of our JDK. Here we can see the JDK installation path, within that the hello world.java. Now, development of the Java program is being successfully done, and JDK is facilitating us for the development is done. Now, the same JDK has to be used to execute the Java program. To execute any program in Windows operating system, we have to use the MS-DOS command prompt. MS-DOS command prompt can be used. At the beginning, we said the Java programming language is both compiled and it is interpreted. First, the program will be compiled, and then the same compiled program will be interpreted. So, our hello world.java our hello world.java, which is in the bin directory, it has to be executed. Execution involves two steps. First step is compilation. Second step is interpreter, compiler, interpreter. The first step is compiler and the second step is interpreter. What compiler it is going to do and what interpreter is going to do, we will discuss now. Compiler and interpreter's job is to convert the source code into the machine language so that our processor can understand that, our machine can understand that program. Here if it is both compiled and interpreted, it is, that means our machine is not converted into the machine code twice, but instead the execution of the Java program goes in this way. We have our hello world.java. In short, we will write it as HW, hello world. This hello world.java, it is being compiled first. So we give our hello world.java to the compiler. This compiler, when it is compiled successfully, if the program is not having any errors, the program will be compiled successfully by the compiler, and an equivalent intermediary code will be created. Intermediary code will be created. This intermediary code is called as dot class 5 byte code also. It can also be called as a byte code. This byte code is having the extension the dot class. This dot class is understandable by the interpreter. So this byte code has to be given as input to the interpreter, which interprets the byte code and converts the byte code into appropriate machine language. Which can be understandable by the machine, and we can be able to see the output. Our very first program, very Java program, hello world program, it is being given to the compiler. The compiler, it is going to compile the program to check if there are any errors in the hello world.java program. If there is no any such error found by the compiler, it is going to successfully create an intermediary code, also called as a byte code. How my Java program is having a .java file as the extension, the intermediary code or the byte code created by the compiler is having an extension as a .class file. This .class file is given as an input to the interpreter. It is given as an input to the interpreter, which interprets each and every statement of the program and converts that each and every statement into the machine understandable language. We may have a doubt, why it is both compiled and interpreted? Why it is both compiled and interpreted? Java is a Vora concept. Is based on Vora concept. That means Vora stands for write once, run anywhere. Write once and run anywhere. JDK is available in the different platforms, Windows, Linux, etc. The reason our Java program, why it is both compiled and interpreted, is we can develop the Java program in our Windows operating system and it can be interpreted in Linux operating system. We can develop and compile, basically development and compile in Windows operating system, and we can interpret the byte code in Linux operating system. We have compilers and interpreters different for different platforms. We have a JDK for Windows, we have a JDK for Linux, which has both compiler and interpreter built in that JDK. Whatever the byte code the compiler generates in whichever the platform that we have created. Right now we have creating our hello world.java in Windows operating system. in Windows operating system. The .java file is in Windows operating system. When it is being compiled, it creates a dot class file. The dot class file will be having a name. Everything, every file should have a name. In our case, whatever the Java program that we are compiling, in our case it is helloworld.java, then the file name of the dot class file will also be helloworld.java. So helloworld.java will be my class file name. So this class file name, it can be taken to the Linux operating system and given the interpreter of the Linux operating system, the program can be executed successfully. Java is based on a Vora concept, write once, run anywhere. You are writing only once in Windows operating system, but you can execute the compiled bytecode, the dot class file, in Linux operating system, which can be executed not only in Linux, in any other different platforms it can be executed. So the universal concept is the bytecode, that whatever the compiler it is getting generated, the bytecode is being understandable by all the available interpreters of different platforms also. So it is very important to note that we have a Java program in one platform and we can execute it in any of the other platforms any number of times. There is no need to develop the Java program once again for the different platforms. So that is the main advantage of our both compiled and interpreter. We don't have to develop the Java programs once again for different platforms. The bytecode, that whatever it has been developed or created by one platform, it is understandable by all the other different platforms. So for all the other different platforms, assume that in Windows operating we are creating our dot class file. In the Linux, we can have only the runtime environment which can execute this bytecode that is created in Windows operating system. We might think like, since it is both compiled and interpreted, our Java programs will run slower. Yes, it is. Compared to our C and C++ programs, our Java programs will run slower, but on the other hand, we have an advantage with the help of both compiled and interpreter, is that our interpreter can be different for different platforms, but the bytecode, that whatever the compiler is creating, it is understandable by all the other things. So there is no need to develop the dot class file or the dot Java file once again for the different platforms. There is no need to create the dot class file once again in the different platforms. So when our Java program, now it is being created, that is helloworld.java, it has to be both compiled and interpreted. Then execution always has two steps: compilation, interpretation. So how to compile the Java program and how to interpret the Java program? In order to execute our Java program, it has to be both compiled and interpreted. So how to compile the Java program? To compile the Java program, we have to use a command, javac. Javac stands for Java compiler. This is a command which facilitates for us to convert our .java file into corresponding dot class file. The dot class file, initially it will not be available. When we compile the dot java file. If there are no errors in the dot java file, our dot class file will be created successfully by the Java C compiler. Hello world.java. When it is given to the compiler Java C, it creates hello world.class file, which is called as a byte code or an intermediary code. This class file is understandable by our interpreter. Our interpreter is called as JVM, Java Virtual Machine, and the command to interpret our dot class file is Java. So with the help of the Java command, we can interpret our each and every statement of the program into corresponding machine language, and then we can get the output. Let us see how to use the Java C and the Java command. In order to use the Java C and the Java command, the syntax is very simple. Java C syntax. Java programs. Can be executed in DOS prompt, command prompt. To execute the Java program, the first step is the compiling the program with the help of a Java C command. The Java C command accepts, there are so many parameters are there. First we will do the basic compilation process. The Java C command, once given a space, we have to provide the file name of the Java which we have to compile, hello world.java in our case. If there are no errors in our .java file, it creates a byte code called hello world.class. This hello world.class, it has to be given as an input to our JVM or a runtime environment. So the command to interpreter is Java. A space has to be provided. We have to give the file name of the dot class file. Here we have given the dot Java extension which created hello world dot class. To interpret the hello world dot class file, we have to just give the file name of the class file. No need to provide this dot class extension. When this is given, we will be getting the output as hello world. This hello world statement is being executed because this main method is, when the Java command is executed, it is being given immediately. It will search for the first thing, it is search for the okay, that what class I have to execute now, hello world. I have to execute Java hello world, means the JVM will come to know that I have to concentrate on the hello world class. Okay, hello world class is there. Then where I have to start, already the JVM or the compiler is, once again it is a software program, it has already been written in the JVM that entry point to execute any class is the main method. So the JVM will search for the main method. When it is available, it will immediately come inside the main method. The first statement inside the main method is the printing statement of hello world. If there is no syntactical errors, the compiler will compile the source file. It creates a dot class file. When this dot class file is given as an input to our JVM, it prints the output hello world, which we will see it now. Open the command prompt. Our Java program, it is in the bin directory, that is the JDK installation path. So let us navigate to the JDK installation path with the help of a cd command, change directory command. So we are in the bin folder. Why we navigated to the bin folder is our .java file is there in the bin directory. Yes, but what was the purpose of saving our .java file only in the bin directory? The reason is our bin directory has the commands for compiler and interpreter. So when we look into the bin folder, it is having the both Java and the Java C command, and hence we have developed our program in bin directory. So execute our Java program. Java C is the command. First step, compilation, Java C hello world.java. When we execute this, right now there are no dot class file, it is being created. When we compile our dot java file, automatically our JDK, it is creating the dot class file. This dot class file is a bytecode called or intermediary code, which is understandable by all the other available different platforms. This is an intermediary code. We can delete it once again. Deletion is done. We will recreate it once again. So dot class file is being created automatically by the JDK. So JDK is facilitating for us to develop the Java program, to develop the Java program and to execute the same. How it is doing? The JDK, it is providing all the available required libraries for us, because our text editor Notepad, it is not having any libraries of its own for our Java program in support. Our class, it is a keyword. How come our Notepad is knowing about the class keyword or a public keyword or static keyword, how about the system.out.println? Our Notepad doesn't know, but our Java C command know. Our Java command knows. How Java C and the Java command, it is interdependent on so many libraries. So it is creating, the JDK is creating an environment for us to develop the Java program and execute the same. The execution first step compilation is done successfully. We can see the structure of the bytecode. When you open this bytecode, it is not usually in a human readable format. It is something in a different format which our machine can understand. When this program is interpreted, our machine can understand, that is our JVM can understand this bytecode. Our Java virtual machine can understand this bytecode. Our next step is to interpret it. So interpreter command is only Java. To this Java, we have to give only the name of the class file, hello world.class. When we give this one, we will be able to see the output hello world. Here we are seeing hello world output. So these are the steps that we have to follow in developing and executing our program. Let us develop the same Java program in some other directory and see what will be the behavior of our programs.